Hi, I'm Kevin Nickerson at the University of Pittsburgh. Today I'm previewing our paper, Age-Associated B Cells are Heterogeneous and Dynamic Drivers of Autoimmunity in Mice. Age-Associated B Cells, or ABCs, are a B cell subset expanded in patients with some autoimmune diseases or chronic bacterial or viral infections. In humans, they are sometimes called atypical memory or DN2 B cells, while in mice they have often been defined by the expression of CD11c, CD11b, and TBET, or by the absence of other subset markers. In autoimmunity, ABCs have been proposed to be autoreactive memory B cells and the precursors to autoantibody-forming cells. However, the extent to which they contribute to disease and their relationship to other B cell subsets remains unclear. To explore these questions, we sought to characterize ABCs in the MRL-LPR preclinical mouse model of lupus. We identified three B cell subsets expressing CD11c, CD11b, or both. Of these, the two CD11c expressing subsets had the most TBET. The ABC-like subsets differed in the degree to which they expressed the plasmablast marker CD138, with CD11c single positives containing the most CD138 expressing cells. These subsets were also heterogeneous with respect to expression of CD80, PD-L2, and CD73, which in other contexts are markers of B cell memory. CD11c and B double positive cells were more likely to express these memory markers. But are the ABC subsets really resting memory B cells? Each of the three subsets contained 20 to 30% Ki67 positive cells, a higher fraction than in the follicular or marginal zone B cell compartments, but not as high as in the plasmablast compartment. Moreover, with a combination of BRDU labeling up and label chase experiments, we found that half of the ABCs took up BRDU within 9 days, and the majority of those lost their label quickly, suggesting considerable proliferation within or flux through the compartment. In an adoptive transfer system, we found that CD11c, CD11b double positive ABCs proliferate rapidly in vivo. While some transferred ABCs maintained the ABC phenotype for up to 21 days post-transfer, many had differentiated to plasmablasts or even entered the germinal center compartment at later times after transfer. Using single-cell RNA-seq with 5' VDJ analysis on total MRL-LPR splenic B cells, we identified naive, ABC, and plasmablast clusters, as well as some putative transitional states. We were able to identify numerous shared B cell clones between the ABC and plasmablast compartments, shown here as the darker red boxes. Finally, in a mixed bone marrow chimera system in which CD11c positive B cells could be constitutively deleted without affecting CD11c positive dendritic cells, we showed that CD11c positive ABCs contribute to renal pathology in lupus, although autoantibody titers did not appear to be affected. In conclusion, ABCs are phenotypically heterogeneous. While they can express memory markers, many of them are proliferative, and they can differentiate out of the phenotype into plasmablasts. In the absence of CD11c positive ABCs, interstitial nephritis is improved, suggesting that targeting ABCs may be beneficial in lupus. I'd like to thank my co-authors at the University of Pittsburgh, Yale University, and University of Louisville, as well as funding from the Lupus Research Alliance and the National Institutes of Health. If you're interested in learning more, please click on the link below to read our paper at the Journal of Experimental Medicine. Thank you for watching.